which is, or the SRB itself is not expensive, but this Delta Deluxe winglets are, and also here the liquid fueled middle stage. So the staging is not looking good, because the two satellites would detach too early, but now I think it is looking fine. Yes, it is. So let's go here to build it. It will take 24 days. And yeah, as you might have seen, I selected this from the Steam library. There was the Steam logo, and you can download this craft from my Steam Workshop. As you can also download the build list. Yep, there it is. Don't save. As you can also download the other craft which we are going to use for the polar satellite. Yeah, I have uploaded really a lot of stuff to the Steam Workshop. I think with 60 something, about 1% of the crafts in the Steam Workshop are from me. So anyway, this is basically the same thing as the two satellites that we are going to launch at once, but also equipped with, as you can see, with some experiments. So let's retract the solar panels and select the... Here you can see Octo Orbital Probe, and we are now going to select the Junkyard 1.2 meter rocket, but not without placing a decoupler. And as you can see, I'm very creative with my names that I give to my crafts. So, but we are not going to need these in order to reduce the build time and to reduce the price. So staging would be like this. And I think we can also launch that one, but of course we will name it High Kelvin Probe or something like that. So everything is looking good, so I think we can also build this one. And so yeah, let's leave the VAB. Do not save. And warp to complete. And we can roll that one out. Actually, it was not the best decision to do the missions in the order that we are doing now, but I only realized that after I accepted this two contracts between the last video and now. And yeah, so we're going to launch. Let's go into the map view and deactivate relays. Actually, this two stay putniks are shown as probes, so we will have to deactivate probes, and of course make this vessel, because it doesn't carry any scientific experiments, as the Staputniks technically do too, we will rename the vessel into a relay. This is good. So activate SAS, set up full thrust, and maybe open the orbit info window, because the orbit info from the Kerbal Engineer obviously is blocked by the persistent rotation window. So SAS is on, and let's go. And I think if we just deactivate SAS like we do now, it will be like better at pointing prograde, because the aerodynamic force is just pointed that way. Oh no, this was not good, this was not good, I pressed the wrong button. So let's revert to launch. Stupid me. So let's just do the same things again. And what I actually wanted to do just now was to head into the map view and select the moon as target, because the moon is at an inclination of 0 degrees, as is our equatorial orbit. So by selecting the moon as target, we can see the like if we are going the right way for our destination orbit for the first of the two satellites. So everything is looking good. Let's go and hope that I do not make the same stupid mistake again. Actually, there is the stage lock function for exactly the same, or for exactly that reason. I'm actually surprised that the two boosters do not collide, because usually they do. And we can open the stage recovery window to see the refunds coming in. Actually, as you can see here, I have installed the missing history mod, which makes the Reliant and the Swivel engine look more like the updated models that came with the Making History mod, the Making History DLC, that makes them look like the models of the engines that came with the Making History DLC. And so once we are in space, we can jettison the second stage, and by activating the second stage, we will also activating the third stage or first stage here in the staging overview, we will also jettison the payload fairing to save weight, or to shed weight. And The reaction wheels of the two probe cores actually are not that strong. But now we are pointing prograde. Yeah, there you can see 1300 refunds only for the small boosters and almost 4000 refunds for the large core stage. So anyway, we are in space. Let's activate the next stage and circularize our orbit. I just realized that perhaps my memory about this dual satellite launch rocket was a bit wrong, and we can only put satellite into, or we will only put them into the low carbon orbit, and then are facing the problem of I don't know if the delta V is enough to bring them up there. So let's just release the upper satellite at first, switch to it, and we will have 1200 meters of delta, 1200 meters per second of delta V. So I think the green one was the stationary orbit. Yes, it is. Which is easier to reach. So let's just give it a go. I'm not gonna stop it. There's two satellites in the right where they belong. So let's warp to here. I should have extended I should also already have released the other satellite and extended its antennas, so hopefully it does not run out of electricity. Is going at full thrust or nose thrust is a bad habit of me. I think we actually have. Yes, we have completed it. This was already. This was not precise at all. What I just did there. Let's see. Our orbital period is 30 minutes too short. It's not really stationary, but anyway, we are not going to complain. And go over to the other satellite. And here we are, let's decouple it from the launcher. And extend the solar panels before it is too late, but it still is full of electric charge. So activate SAS, activate the engine, and had probe rate at first. I pressed the wrong button again. Anyway, it will not run long, so even if coolant is leaking, the risk of overheating is not too high. The danger of overheating. Around here. So actually I'm right now doing this without any maneuver planning, so upgrading the mission control and the tracking station wasn't all that necessary. Time warp here. I don't know if this satellite has to be launched with the same precision as the first one. Let's have a look. Not here, but there it is. Capcom active. With reasonable deviation, whatever that means. It means that. So we have completed the second contract and now are at 100,000 funds, I think. So what is the problem with this one? I mean, it is a new unmanned probe and everything, and we maintain stability for 10 seconds, but for some reason it does not accept it. This is... So I thought that was, I would be smart and launch two satellites at once in order to save funds, but it doesn't count seemingly. Maybe I should have tried that before. So, but I mean we accepted the, or I accepted the contract before I built this vessel and everything, and yeah, things are weird. So let's head into the space center. Yeah, so we will just build yet another one of the of this single launch, like we did before, the single launch satellites. So where is it? Octo-orbital probe. But remove all the experiments to make it cheaper. solar panel. Don't save. And select the junkyard 1.2 meter rocket. And of course not without placing a decoupler in between. Okay. But it will be named RA2. Because when I build some relays, I always like to name them after the antenna. So we won't need these. And build. Show and hide the build list. Yeah, let's leave the VAB. Do not save. And I'm not even sure if I remembered to retract the solar panels on this one. So edit. Yes, I did. Save edits. And remove this alarm and warp to complete. And warp to complete. And roll it out and warp to complete. And launch. And what we are going to do now is head into the map view again and wait until, so we are here, yeah, until it is a little bit into the night, because if we are now, we were now going to launch into, let's say, southward direction again, we would actually, or if we wanted to launch southwards, we would have to wait even more until the KSC is about here, let's maybe 30 degrees of the beginning of the day side of Kerbin. So let's do some careful time warping until now. Activate. Nah, we ran out of electricity. This is not going well today. So let's revert to launch. And this time activate hibernation in order to save electric charge. We have 110 EC, so this should be enough to last for about 5 hours until the launch window comes up. But let's better keep a close eye onto the electric charge consumption. So here we are, ready to launch to the south, deactivate hibernation. And actually the reason that I now decided to use the satellite without any it is without any science equipment for this launch is just because with the little bit weight that is or with the little bit weight that it lost, it will have of course a higher delta V, and thus is better suited for this this polar orbit where we cannot take the momentum from the rotation of Kerbin. So anyway, stop talking and not your eastwards, but pitch southwards. I nearly launched eastwards by force of habit. So yeah, we will already be in space when the middle stage detaches. So we can also jettison the fairing when we do so. Let's time warp a little. And, the reaction wheels cannot compensate the aerodynamic forces. Extend solar panels to prevent some electric problems, and so polarize the orbit. So yeah, I think we will just increase our altitude until we are very close to the target orbit, and then adjust the inclination and finally adjust the altitude. So we will have to make our burn to raise the apoapsis about here or up here. speaking when I when there is the small what's it called, the spark. The engine is burning because it is quite loud, and actually when I was doing my reinstallation I have adjusted some of the volumes of the game. So let's warp around here and go radial in would be this one, I guess. Board like this, yes, looking good. And let's time warp to upwapsis, actually, to raise the, or in order to raise the periapsis. Warp here. And we have 288 meters per second left of delta V. Let's just hope that it's enough to do the job. Wait, we will have to go a little bit down. Anyway, we are on the scanning node, so we will have to go into normal direction. We've run out of fuel. Yeah, I think this would be stuff for a future episode to to actually bring this, yeah, nearly disaster or this total failure to an end with only one of three satellite launches actually being successful. So yeah, I'm a bit bit angry about myself, about the stupid how to say, overly ambitious goals that I set today that are obviously, or were obviously not possible to reach. So anyway, if you nevertheless enjoyed it, even if it was a total failure, you can feel free to leave a like and check subscribe to my channel, and also check out my main channel, and I hope to see you again in the next episode.